the fabrics. And I'm Chileshe Mumbi, Siwale. I'm the co-founder and executive director of McChile Fabrics, which is trading as House of African Fabrics Zambia. House of African Fabrics is all about selling and supplying of fabric. We supply different African markets, mostly in the Southern African region. And our main distributing point is based in Lusaka, Zambia. That's where we are based, and that's where we have like a warehouse where we have our offices. And our target markets are African countries, mostly Central Africa and Southern Africa. And we are planning to expand more to European countries. Though we have a few European countries that we are supplying where we have plans, but we also want to try and expand that market a little bit. Maybe you can answer.
So the whole idea came from my wife. She got from where she was working from. There was someone who used to supply in African fabrics. So she got interested from there.
Like he has said, I got inspired from the person who was selling fabric, who I decided to become more of like his agent. But other than that, also the employment levels in Zambia, they are too high. So we decided to say, okay, let's set up this business and see if we could create employment for especially the newly graduate students and those who want to start like their own businesses. Then also the gap, there was a lot of gap, and still there is a big gap in the African green supply on the market, especially within Africa, because the focus now is mainly on the West African countries like Nigeria and Ghana. So we are trying to make a difference in this part of Africa and trying to promote the African print material so that even this side of Africa, people and women are able to embrace it and use it more often than the European styles.
That outline, you know, what with a partner who you say you love, and as a husband you become like you're the boss, you know. But she came up with this idea, and I had another business which I used to do, but I said her idea is more, it was more trending than what I was doing, so I had to worry what I was doing, and I had to support my wife. You know, women empowerment is something we've put aside as Africans. So I said, no, let me make a change and support my wife. Yeah.
I think what differentiates us is mostly the quality of material and also the uniqueness in the prints. Because the prints that we usually provide to our clients are the prints which are common on the West African market. And everyone I've seen or come across, like clients, they'll come with pictures like from a Nigerian website or a Ghanaian website to say, I'm looking for this material. And if like we were not supplying these types of material, I don't think it would be easy to find them within Zambia or within our hometown, Lusaka. It's very difficult. But we saw the need and said, okay, let's try to be different. Let's provide something unique, which like people want to have. And we maintain that uniqueness so that we don't like put on the market what everyone is selling.
Just to add on, and when you look at the Zambian market, most of the materials we find, they come from Congo, like Tanzania. But most of our products, they come from the western side, which is difficult to find on the Zambian market. Maybe just on the southern part. So that's one of the differences we have with our products.
and also we are able to make it like our own design of a print, which even if someone else was to say, go to each market in Zambia and say we are looking for this print, they will say we don't have it. Even if they try to book it maybe from their source in DRC, even there they will say no, we don't have it, bring a sample for the fabric so that we reproduce. And that has been happening. We've had people come to say no, just cut a piece of the fabric, and yet they want to go and reproduce that fabric. And that's why we decided in our business that we won't be cutting fabrics, we'll just be doing business on wholesale, and we are going to make sure that all the fabrics are not cut, we sell full pieces.
Our advice, my fellow men out there, to support their wives. The reason being, most of, say, our African culture, we've been looking so down on women. We think women should be working for us, you know, just doing housework and the like. But you know, nowadays there's what we call women empowerment. These women, these ladies, they've got ideas which, if we do not help them, they do not come out. We don't see what they have in them, you know. So I just ask them to work with their ladies, to work with their wives. Yeah.
I think for someone to start, I always say business is an idea. Someone doesn't need like a lot of money to start up something. I think the best is for them to come out in the open and also try to attend as many forums as possible, because it is through those forums that you get to understand what is happening out there, and also you might meet someone who you share the same business idea with, and you can link up and start up your business. I think most women are so much in a closed up, more of like a closet. They don't want to come out because they are scared of how will my husband look at me. Maybe my husband will think I'm not respecting him because he's not being supportive. And yet some have not even sold their ideas to their husband. So I think the best is to come out in the open and also showcase what they have, what talents they have. Like I talked about during my speech there, I'm a human resource specialist. I was not born an entrepreneur. It was just in me. It was an idea. I saw the potential and I developed an idea. And I developed a very different business model of how I'm going to set out this business. And I thank God it has worked, and my husband has been very supportive, even when sometimes we cross paths, but he's been very supportive.
Yes, Africa means wake up Africa. You know, Africans, I don't know why we depend so much on other people. At the same time, we just stood up and fought. We have to fight for ourselves, you know. That's what Yes, Africa means for me. It's wake up Africa.
For me, I think Yes, Africa means a lot to me. But from an entrepreneur point of view, it means wake up, spread your wings, and shine, and achieve what you want to achieve. Because if you just sit down, no one will come to you and say, Chileshe, do this or do that. It's up to you as an African. And being African, I'm proud to implement and market this business within Africa. And I'm also willing to support other African women, even young men who are willing to like start their businesses in this line of business, because the unemployment levels in Africa are just so high and people don't know what to do next. They are just early in the morning, as early as 7, they are busy drinking in bars, walking around, roaming the streets. But if going by the Yes African, if you bring these people as entrepreneurs in our forums, we engage them, we support them and empower them, because it's not always that you want to work with someone who already has capital. Sometimes you provide them an opportunity by giving them the capital they need so that they can move forward.